Good early Saturday morning. Happy Saturday, everyone. Hope you guys are doing well. You see in the title, it says, does tradition keep us stuck? Does tradition keep us stuck? I have a power nugget I want to share with you all this morning. I was riding with my daughter, I believe it was yesterday, and we started talking about the nursery rhyme, Ring Around the Rosie. Now, as I was coming on to share with you all, I was like, where did that come from in our conversation? So maybe something came on the radio. I believe that may have been what it was. I'm not sure. But in the process, she reminds me of something she had shared with me a few years back. She said, Ma, you do know what that means, right? And I'm like, what is that? And she said, the nursery rhyme, Ring Around the Rosie. And she said, to think, they taught us that in school. And I was singing that song. I remember singing that song in grade school. And I said, I remember you sharing something with me about it before, but what is it? And she said that one of her history teachers told her that the nursery rhyme actually came into being during the time of Hitler and something he would do at concentration camps. And then she asked, what does Rosie even mean? And I said, well, I don't know. We'll have to look that up. And so, you know, we were talking about how there's so many things that we just start singing or doing that we have no earthly idea what it really means. So one, I want to say this morning, with all thy getting, get understanding. With all thy getting, get understanding. So many times in life, we just accept what is, or we accept what has been tradition. And we don't even really know, like, is there another way? Or what is the meaning behind this? So this morning, I got up and I Google searched Ring Around the Rosie. Now, I didn't find anything that my daughter said her history teacher told her some years back. So here we go with that. So I'm glad that I did do some more research, not to say that what she was told isn't true, but it also talked about the fact that the nursery rhyme was kind of a dark nursery rhyme because it was started during a time of the Black Plague. And so Ring Around the Rosie was like this type of rash or something that was depicted of having, you know, the Black Plague. And Pocket Full of Posies, they were saying that the posies were this like type of, like, let's say a talisman or something that would ward off the plague. So anyway, that's one thing, tradition. And it made me think about all the songs that we sing and all of the phrases that we say and all of the actions even that we take that we really don't even know where they originated from. We really don't even know like what the real meaning of some of the things that we say come from. I can think about songs I sang as a little girl. And then when I got older, I'm like, whoa, you know, I had no idea that is what that meant. And for me in this season, especially because I understand the power of words, I just think it's important that with all of our getting, we get understanding. Good morning. Good morning. I see you guys joining. If this is your first time, let me know in the comments, what type of business do you own? How do you rock out in the marketplace? How do you serve? How do people get to experience your greatness? If you're an entrepreneur, let me know the name of your business. Number two, if it isn't your first time, put hashtag renew in the comments. Renew is the name of my consulting business, Renew Full Circle, because we get our whole life over here. I teach abundance mindset, personal growth, and business building strategies to women in business just like you. And thirdly, little favor, if you come on this broadcast, even on the replay, hey there, replay viewer, there's a little button on the left. It says share. Something magical happens when you press it. It allows you to share the message out with someone else who could use a power nugget this morning, right? And we're talking about tradition. Like, does tradition keep us stuck? I also remember this other story I'd heard. I love to cook, guys, right? So if you've been following me, gardening is also a habit of mine, or something that I enjoy. And of course, it ties in so much with cooking. But I remember this particular story. And stories matter, guys. For those of you who are building brands and you're looking to attract your perfect people, remember that stories matter. They're normally an attraction system for your perfect people. I'm actually inside my 3D Success Academy this month. We're talking about niches and brand story and brand message and things of that nature. But this particular story that I want to share with you now probably stuck with me, and I remembered it because I enjoy cooking. So I remember hearing a story told about a lady who, this was like her first year cooking a really big dinner for her family, and she was cooking a pot roast, and she cut the end off of the pot roast, and either her children, hey Stacy, good morning, darling, either her children or maybe her spouse asked her, why did she cut the end off of the pot roast before putting it in the pan? And she said, well, this is the way that my mom did it. So I believe it was the husband or the child. So either the spouse or the child asked the lady's mother, mom cuts her pot roast off at the end. And she said, she does it because you do it. Why do you cut the pot roast off at the end before putting it in the pot? And then the grandmother says, well, I just do it because my mother did it. So luckily this is a healthy family and they have several generations who are still living. And they asked the great grandmother, I guess this would be to the child. And she said, oh, my mother used to cut the pot roast off at the end because she didn't own a pot that was big enough to cook the whole thing. And so all these years, traditionally, that family or those families have been cutting and discarding the end of the pot roast because they saw someone else do it, but no one bothered to ask why. No one bothered to go deeper. No one bothered to get full understanding. How many things do we do in our life? Do you ever ask yourself the question why? Listen, your life will change and your life will shift when you begin to question everything. Now, I don't mean question everything as in not trusting, you know, not having any form of trust or you know, being able to accept the wisdom of others. That's not what I'm saying. But there's so many things that you're doing right now in your everyday life that you picked up traditionally. This is the way mom folds it. This is what my mom does. Have you ever just sat and thought about certain things and asked why? Why is it that way? Is there another way that this can be done? Listen, guys, when I begin to question tradition, when I begin to question things that were passed down, everything in my life changed. As I'm sharing this with you all this morning, and this is supposed to be a power nugget, so it's supposed to be really quick, but things are coming up for me. But I remember in my previous marriage how I saw things that were being done that were traditionally being done from my spouse's family. And nobody ever really questioned it, right? They just kind of did it, no matter how it impacted the family and those connected. And that just came up for me, you know, as we were talking. And I think it's huge for me, too, because I researched my family tree back in 2001. And I began asking the question, like, why? Like, does anybody else see these patterns? Does anyone else see that everybody's life is ending up the same, or everybody's making the same decisions and they're not great results, right? So begin to, you know, just kind of sift through. We're actually doing discovery inside 3D Success Academy this particular month. And discovery comes from asking questions And sometimes it's the things we do traditionally. I was listening to a podcast on yesterday while I was prepping all of that stuff that I got from my garden. And I was listening to the gentleman. They were talking about money and the shortage. Hey, Jasmine, how are you, dear? That we're seeing with change in the different stores, and how people are saying they don't have coins to return to you in certain spaces. But anyway, it led to them talking about the fact that when you put money in a bank, the FDIC insures your money, right? But they only insure your money up to $250,000. So if the banks were to crash or something of that nature, and you had over $250,000 in the bank, there is a chance, you know, that the FDIC is not responsible for insuring the money that's over, you know, the 250. And I said, how many people just go to the bank? You never ask questions. You don't have, you know, any concerns, just traditionally, you know, doing things that we do it because that's what's always been done. We just always felt that this is what everyone does and this is the safe way and all of the things. But I just wanted to ask you the question this morning. Does tradition keep us stuck? Are we living lives that look similar to people before us? And although they may be comfortable, in our heart of hearts, we feel that there's more. But because we've aligned so much of what we do, so much of what we listen to, so much of how we do things to tradition, we never bother to go deeper. When you get to a certain space in your journey, especially when you're designing your destiny, which is also a track inside the academy, but when you get to a specific space in your journey, you start questioning things. You become a creator and not a consumer. Consumers kind of just do what's normal. We just kind of consume what's already there. But when you step into the space of creation, you begin asking questions that shift and change the trajectory of your life, your business, your results, your happiness, and your peace. Does tradition keep us stuck? Hey guys, that's my power nugget for today. Just ask yourself just a couple questions. Is this tradition? Why am I doing it this way? Like, am I doing it because somebody else is doing it that way? And I never bothered to ask why. I never bothered to ask, is there another way? I never bothered to even ask the internal questions within me. For those of you who are believers, we have the Holy Spirit resting and residing on the inside of us, waiting to give us new answers, waiting to give us things that will renew and transform our minds and our lives. Do we even ask those questions? You guys have a super amazing day. Hope you've enjoyed this power nugget. Does tradition keep us stuck? For those of you wanting to connect outside of social media, you can always go to renewfullcircle.com. I'm Tanya Wilson-Cherry, the Growth Strategist. Peace.